shared with you that the annular eclipse created a menorah in the heavens. There are seven planets all lined up. Venus, Saturn, the Moon, the Sun, Jupiter, Mercury, and Mars. And the annular solar eclipse was the middle section of this sign. This is the menorah. And this is the midweek Hanukkah sign.
When God weighs us as individuals, what's he going to weigh us by? What's on the other side of the scales? You see, here's the scales. Here's you, and here's what God weighs you by. First, he'll weigh you by the Ten Commandments. How do you stand up with the Ten Commandments? Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not murder. All of these are taken in the Ten Commandments. And the Bible says if we offend in one point, we are guilty of all. If you've broken one commandment one time in your life, it's the same as breaking all of them. Well, you say, well, of course I've broken at least one or two of them. Well, then you're guilty of all. And that's the reason the Bible says we're all guilty. That's the reason Jesus said, you that are without sin, pick up the first stone and throw it at this woman taken in adultery. None of these religious leaders could do it. Because we all have sinned. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And all are under the judgment of God. Then not only are we going to be weighed by the Ten Commandments, but we're going to be weighed by the law of love. Matthew 22, Jesus said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments, said Jesus, hang all the law and all the teaching of the prophets. It's all summed up in love. Do you love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul? And do you love your neighbor? Now, your neighbor means anybody that's in need. Jesus taught that in the parable of the Good Samaritan. Anyone who's in need, you love that neighbor as much as you love yourself. That's what Jesus said. We're going to be weighed by that law. Thirdly, we're going to be weighed by the person of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Psalm 89, for who in the heaven can be compared unto the Lord? Who among the sons of the mighty can be likened unto the Lord? Isaiah said, to whom will be likened me and make me evil or equal and compare me that they should be like me? God says, be ye holy, for so I am holy. If you don't know, Jesus Christ was the only righteous and the only holy man that ever lived. We call some people in India holy men. But Jesus was the only truly holy man of history. And if we don't live like Jesus and live as good as Jesus is, then we come short of God's requirement and God's expectation. Will you say, Billy, who in the world can live like Jesus? Nobody. That's the reason you all have to say, I'm a sinner. God is going to weigh us by Christ. He's going to weigh us by the Ten Commandments. He's going to weigh us by the law of love. But he's also going to weigh you by your works. Those sins of omission that you weren't even conscious of. In Matthew 25, Jesus reminds us, for I was a-hungered, and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty. Then he answered him this way. Inasmuch as you did it not to one of the least of these, you did it not to me. Now that strikes every person in this arena. And we come short. And then Jesus pronounced judgment. He said, those that are guilty of the sin of omission, and these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous unto life eternal. You say, well, Billy, I'm sort of devastated. How can any of us weigh up? We can't. Jesus said in Revelation 3, I know your works, that you're neither hot nor cold. I would that you were hot or cold. So then, because you're lukewarm, I'm going to spew you out of my mouth, he said. Listen, there are going to be a lot of people that are going to miss heaven that you think are going to be there. And then fifthly, he's going to weigh us by our opportunities. By our opportunities. To whom much is given, much shall be required, he said. Much is required. You say, well, Billy, even on that score, I can't make it. No. But the glory of this whole thing is that there is a gospel. And the gospel is good news to people like you who are sitting there saying, well, I'm guilty. The good news is that God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to the cross to die for you. And God took those sins of yours and those failures of yours and laid them on Christ. He became sin for us. Now he said, the just and the righteous are going to get to heaven. How am I going to get a justness and a righteousness of my own when I don't have any? I'm a sinner. I don't weigh enough to get to heaven. But on the cross, Christ provided a justness for me. He provided a righteousness for me that I didn't have. And I am acceptable tonight by God, not because I've been good or because I've read the Bible or because I've preached to crowds of people. I'm acceptable because of Christ. I'm accepted into the beloved because of him. And that's your privilege at this moment. You can appropriate what Christ did on the cross to you right now, and you can leave here weighing enough to get to heaven, weighing enough to have your sins forgiven, weighing enough to live a new life. Thou art weighed in the balances of God and found wanting. Are you found wanting? The last word here is eupharson, divided. Thy kingdom is divided. God said, Belshazzar, I'm taking your kingdom away from you. You're finished. Judgment has come. It's too late. Is God going to say that to you? Judgment has come. It's too late. Is God writing on the wall of America tonight? Meanie, meanie, tekel, eupharson. Have we gone that far? The word many also means remembered. God remembers. God remembers our sins. God sees our pornography. He sees our obscene films, and he sees these new films that are coming out making fun of Jesus Christ. He sees our lying and our cheating and our corruption. It goes all the way through our society. He sees it all. And the scripture says, be sure your sin will find you out. But he remembers something else too. It's not too late. God remembers to forget. When any group of people, any nation, will repent of their sins and turn to the Lord, he'll forgive their sins and heal the land. That's the promise of the Lord. And that happened to Nineveh. Nineveh had the handwriting on the wall. Jonah preached repentance, and the people from the king all the way down repented of their sins, and God spared Nineveh. If we in America will repent of our sins and turn to the Lord, God will spare us. If we don't, the judgments will continue. And I'm saying the judgments will continue because we're under judgment right now. The events of this past year and the events of this present hour would indicate to me that we're already experiencing judgment upon judgment upon judgment that will continue unless we turn to God. We're dealing with the living God, and our God is a consuming fire, the scripture says. But that's true in your life as a person, as an individual. God knows your sins. You can't hide them from him. There's no use trying to cover up. You see, the first